Hello everyone watching our video. I am Naveen and he is Mr. Arjun Devji. He is a yoga teacher. He has been teaching for a long time. He is an experienced yoga teacher. So today in this video we are going to discuss about some precautions for students, as some students are having to study online and there sometimes they feel pain in their eyes and headache sometimes they feel. So what are the precautions, what's the healthy food for them, and how should they study? So these some questions I'm going to ask him. So let's start. My first question is, I mean, how can the student save their eyes?
Okay.
So how can they keep their eyes healthy? Yes.
So dear all the students, I want to suggest to everyone how we can keep our eyes healthy. So there is some precautions for the everyone and for the students also. So firstly, we need to wash our eyes again and again in a day while we are studying. So at the time of study time, after 2 or 3 hours, we can wash our eyes with the normal water like this and keep your eyes open, and then you can wash your eyes like this. So this is the first precautions for the every students, because I have already experience about it. We are washing our eyes again and again in a day about 5 to 6 times, so definitely our eyes looks healthy. And another things, we have some precautions also. We can take amla pickle, amla juice, amla candy, because we know well amla has the highest vitamin C, so that is the best resource of vitamin C in the world. So we can use the amla for the healthy eyes also. And another things, we have some also precautions. We can take some dry fruits like almond and raisin, and also we can take just like a walnut. So these dry fruits are very useful for the every student. We can use these dry fruits early in the morning, and we have to need some good healthy diet, just like cow milk and curd and fruits juice and pulse and chapati. So these are the basic diet for the students for living healthy life and healthy eyes. So it's my suggestion for all.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. And some more things I just want to tell some students, as they study on mobile, just keep your eyes a little away from the mobile, and whenever you feel pain in your eyes, then wash your eyes. And when you feel pain in your eyes, then you do not need to study much for a long time, and you can rest also. And one more, actually yoga, that's kind of asana yoga, he is going to tell us and then to save our eyes. So please, one yoga.
Okay. So keep yes. Mic. So another things I am telling about the yoga practice for the students and for the everyone. So if we want to live our healthy life and if we want to keep our eyes healthy, so we have some yoga practice for our eyes, especially Anulom Vilom Pranayam. So how we can do it, I'm just telling you. Firstly, we will close our nose, right nostril, and breathe in from left like this. Slowly breathe in and press our left nostril and breathe out from right. Again, breathe in from right and breathe out from left. So here, firstly we have to breathe in from right nostril and breathe out from left, and again breathe in from left and breathe out from right. So it's complete one cycle. You can do it about 30 cycles at the time of study time, and also in a day you can do it about 3 to 4 times, about 5 minutes. So it is much useful for every student for healthy eyes, healthy life. And another things we can do also, another yoga practice, that is Brahmi Pranayam. Firstly, we will close our ear like this by the thumb, and both index finger keep on your forehead, and remaining 3 fingers we can touch on our eyes like this, and take deep breath and do Om chanting after close our mouth. Again, take deep breath and do Om chanting. Then slowly come back and pumping, and you can touching on your eyes and slowly open your eyes. So it is much useful for every student. We can do this pranayam about 3 to 5 minutes every day during the study time. So definitely you can keep your eyes healthy. So it's my suggestion for all. You can do these 2 pranayam, anulom vilom and second brahmi pranayam.
Okay, thank you so much, sir, for your kind suggestion. And I request all the students, this is just suggestion for you. You can do it if you wish, but do it with your parents, with the help of your parents, with the help of your brother or sister. You should do it. You should not do it directly as we have told you, and you just sit and do it. So do not do it directly. Please take help of your parents. And brother and sister, whoever elder person is there in your family, you can take help of him. Then do it under his guidance. So this is a kind of a little bit suggestion for your eyes. And because some students, ask such kinds of questions to us. So we have just answered the questions. So thank you so much. And for the next videos, upcoming videos, please subscribe to our channel. And please share our videos to your friends or relatives so that they could also join us and they could also get our suggestions. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Namaste.